That's honestly a huge problem in this game. You go into rooms.
Shot set.
9 out of 10 players have 150 plus ping. Pretty sad because it didn't always. There's not really much you can do. I mean, technically they're at a disadvantage because of their ping difference. So if you play that.
Charge defuse. Operation success. Return to main base. Your efforts are commended.
If you know that they're playing a certain position and you peek them, you have a big advantage over them because they won't see you until after you've turned the corner and are already taking your first shot at them. But the problem comes when they turn a corner. They turn a corner and peek you and they teleport. And by the time you realize what's happened, they're already shooting you and you're already dead because, I mean, if they're
Granted, for me, yeah.
They probably have a Desmodus. So, not much you can do at that point. So, the best thing you can do is play aggressively. Use your map knowledge and game sense to predict where they're going to be and rush the shit out of them.
Yeah, it doesn't really pertain to me too much because I don't see people warp, so.
That's surprising.
It's because of my, goddamn, I can't remember what it was called. My packet loss. I don't have too much packet loss.
Oh. Well, I'll be honest with you, it doesn't happen to me that often. Like, it's not game-breaking. It's not the way that the corner lag.
Target destroyed.
Anyone here is old enough to remember.
Operation
that.
Failure. Return to main base.
Corner warp. Oh, then you mean that? Yeah, I remember that. It's terrible.
Like, there was like almost a year where basically. Even if you weren't Brazilian, like even if you had normal ping, everyone would just teleport around corners. Oops. And it was, the game was like basically unplayable at that point. But it's not like that. Like, it happens occasionally, and it usually happens if the person has high ping. Like, they have to have a combination of high ping and a really unstable connection.
Yep.
And what happens is, like, you'll see them peek out. It's not like the corner lag. Like, you'll see them peek out. Like, their shoulder will come out, and then they freeze in place, and then they appear, like, 5 feet to the left or right.
Enemy troops eliminated. Operation
so
success.
Like,
return to main base. Your efforts are commended.
And it's like, what? And then they appear somewhere else, and by that time, you're already dead, because they've already seen you and killed you.
A good way to watch for that is to see if their ping jumps up and down constantly.
Yeah, exactly.
Even at a low rate, even if they're low ping.
And the way to counter them is to just, you have to peek them first. There's no other way to deal with that.
Nope.
The way the corner lag used to be, though, you wouldn't see their shoulder first. They would just appear, like, 5 feet out from the corner.
That
was game breaking.
Ready to go.
There was
heartbeat.
Nothing
you could do. My
heartbeat. It forced everyone to play.
Charge set.
Really, really.
Friendly troops eliminated. Operation failure. Return to main base.
By corner lag.
Why am I carrying right now?
Because they're awful.
Whenever you are around.
Obviously, no offense to the people that are playing, but the average skill level in this game has really dropped because all the players that are worth a damn have left the game.
Oh, Makimba!
Who gives a goddamn? Who gives a fuck about that guy? He's just a normal player.
He quit though, didn't he?
I think so.
Yeah. I don't know what the Kimpa hype is about, by the way.
I don't get it either.
He's always been a good player. I don't understand why he's getting all this.
Enemy troops eliminated. Operation success. Return
now.
To main base. Your efforts are commended.
He's always been like that.
He's probably been one of the most consistent players, arguably the most consistent player in AVA, like ever. I mean, he's been playing well since, like, 2010, 2011.
Whoopsies.
That whole team, at least in the EU scene, that's been one of the most consistent teams in AVA.
Yeah.
Crackheads lineup. They've been playing together for 3 years. I mean, I think they quit now. Kimpa quit, at least. And the team disbanded, as far as I know.
Pretty sure Quelly's gone, too.
Not surprising. If we were smart, we would be gone, too, so...
Well, I'm smart. I just do it just a stream. No. I would have been gone a long time ago.
Me too.
I've been holding out, like, I was ready to quit, but I found out I could actually stream. So I was just like, okay, well, let me start something going.
The only reason I still play this game is because I have friends that play it. If you're playing this game,
enemy troops eliminated. Operation success. Return to main base. Your efforts are commended.
Because that doesn't mean anything anymore. Like, I wouldn't even consider myself that good at this game.
You're not.
If an average player from like 2 years ago came back today and had the same skill level that they did when they quit, they would basically stomp on everyone because everyone has become so bad. 5 years, that's good for you for sticking with it then. I mean, there's not a lot of people. If you've got 5 years, you've been playing longer than me.
Yep. I've played 5 years, so, yeah.
I played the game for maybe...
3.5, I'm guessing.
6 months. I played it for maybe 6 months when it came out. My computer broke. Didn't touch it again until late 2011, so... And then, even after that, I've been playing sporadically, like, on and off. After 2011, after the merge, I quit for almost a year. Started playing in 2013, played my way back up to my old rank, which was Lieutenant Colonel, got banned, made another account.
Friendly troops eliminated. Operation failure, return to main base. Now.
Not that I give a shit anymore.
Yeah, I've been playing to close beta, so yeah. I've been here for a long time. Super long time, actually.
I played open beta, not closed beta. Yeah. I didn't get in.
I don't even know why I was playing for that long. I had a terrible computer, so.
Yeah, me too. And it was okay. It was a Core 2 Duo Intel.
Oh god, and, gross. Some,
I got it from the state, it wasn't mine. And it ran AVA okay. I got over 100 frames.
This I didn't even have that.
The kind of processor this game was designed to run on anyway, like that was not top of the line, but that was pretty good back then.
Right.
And I played on that, and there was a patch which basically broke the game. Like nobody could play for more than
The FPS patch
nobody
thing.
Could play for more than a game or two before their FPS would tank down.
Yeah, the FPS lag. Yeah, that was terrible.
It was after the E-boat patch, and I basically stopped playing after that. My computer couldn't handle it. And that computer actually ended up breaking anyway, so it's not like I could have come back. So I sold my account and I stopped playing. That was the end of it for quite a while.
Yeah, I remember those days.
You have a good laptop if you can max out AVA. Game is not optimized very well. It likes Intel CPUs and NVIDIA graphics cards.
Mm-hmm.
Anything else is hit or miss.
And it's not. It doesn't like newer NVIDIA graphics cards whatsoever.
It doesn't like DirectX 11.
So if you're gonna get like a 970 or something like that, you're not gonna see too much of a jump in AVA. Because I don't think they directly support the newer ones.
No, they don't. But, I mean, but the cards are backwards compatible, though, obviously.
Well, of course, yeah.
It still works, but it doesn't like it. Obviously, if you have a brand new card with brand new architecture and
user in your channel timed out.
DirectX 11, it's not going to reach its full potential running a game from 2007. Done a lot of programming on you. Oh, good for you, man. From what I understand, that's all like node based or something, so it's really easy to get a lot done.
What's he talking about?
He's talking about Unreal Engine.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, the new one, it's like all node based, so you have basically a UI for everything you're doing, and it's really cool.
That's good.
Yeah, someday. I'd love to learn a little bit about game development. Right now, I was talking to Tyrone about this earlier, I'm actually learning C++.
Have fun with that.
PowerShell, but that's a little less noteworthy.
Friendly troops eliminated.
PowerShell?
Operation failure! Return to main base.
I use PowerShell all the time. I use it all the time, so.
Well, I mean, when you have that kind of job, being able to automate all of your tasks is so, like, the value of that cannot be understated.
Like, they actually lock down, whatchamacallit, command prompt. We have to use PowerShell.
Yeah.
Granted, that's basic knowledge, so it's not really.
Yep, that's what I'm planning to go to school for is CompSci.
Why don't you just join the Air Force, man? Just go client systems or something. Or, I mean, it's something you want to do. I mean,
between Army and Air Force at this point.
John
like,
Seth.
Army, okay, I'll tell you now. There's a guy, he's a client systems guy, and he's on an Army base. They're a lot different compared to like Air Force stuff.
Friendly troops eliminated. Operation failure. Return to main base.
Aggravating. They don't. I don't know how to explain it. It's really bad. I can't stand it sometimes.
Well, let's just put it this way. Whoever pays for me to go to school and gives me benefits and has an attractive looking job for me, that is where I will go. And if that's Air Force, it'll be Air Force. If it's Army, it will be Army. Time will tell. But good for you, man. That's really, really awesome career path to take. I know, even though I'm just getting started, I'm having a lot of fun with it. That's what my dad does, and he's, even after almost 20 years, he has a lot of fun with it.
Yeah. Well, you do have to constantly go to school. Well, not school, but you have to constantly relearn stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Because things change so much.
And it changes so fast. You're always learning something new. But, I mean, if that's the kind of thing that you enjoy learning like that, then, I mean, that's just perfect. Oh, how did you not see that guy? What the hell?
I saw him. I just couldn't hit him. So I was looking for him.
He was like partially obscured by the smoke, okay. It's good that CZ Tyrone. That
it's
English.
Okay, it's bloomy.
Shot set!
It's really bloomy.
Doesn't it shoot slow too?
No, it's just bloomy.
I haven't really used it too much. I think it's a capsule gun in other versions, by the way.
Charge defused.
No, it's the same. It's the same.
Operation success. Return to main base. Your efforts are commended.
There was an event for it in other versions. There was an event where you could get it, and then it became a capsule gun. So it's a capsule gun in at least in Korean and Japanese AVA. It is. I don't know about China. China AVA hardly even counts at AVA at this point. Might as well be a copy of Crossfire. This point.
Man, I'm losing a lot of guys all of a sudden.
You're moving with the DMR, don't do that.
What? Well, I had to get a spot.
Crosshair gets huge though.
I know. But I know how to control that.
Guy in Twitch chat, you were asking about the DMR earlier. If you remember the original M14, you know that the number one rule of M14 is never move while you're shooting.
I defy those rules.
And that's why you missed like 3 shots.
I don't care. I was in an awkward spot anyway.
I would never rush unless I was a point man or I had someone smoke it and flash it. There's a strat that Epic showed me where you throw your smoke. I can't remember what he called it, but you throw the smokes on the bridge and run through them.
Oh, I know what you're talking about.
The mangoose. Yeah.
The mangoose.
Friendly troops eliminated.
Why would he pick up the scope?
Operation failure. Return to main base.
The mangoose. That sounds like something you would make up.
It does. It works anywhere where there's a long straightaway. So you could do it on bridge. You could do it.
Right.
Mid on India. You could do it at You could do it at street on dual site. You could do it anywhere.
Not good.
Like, and it's hilarious because nobody expects that either. Like, usually you throw a smoke and it's a defensive measure. You throw a smoke and you back up because they don't push through smoke because it puts you at a disadvantage if you do. So they go to back up a little bit and take a position, and lo and behold, two people come sprinting out of the smoke.
Holy shit! No! What is he doing?
What can you do?
What? Oh my goodness, did that just happen? Oh.
Oh, by the way, does the box strat still work on this map?
I mean, it works, but I wouldn't use it.
I never learned how to do that, and so I can't accurately test to see if it still works, because I still have no idea how to do it.
I don't know how to do it, but I know it works.
Charge set!
How I thought it was done, and if it does still work, then obviously I did it wrong, because it didn't work. I think you have to, like, sprint against the bottom box and have someone break it while you're sprinting or something, but I have no idea.
Friendly troops eliminated.
I will ask.
Operation failure. Return to main base.
Barrel strat.
Oh god, yeah. Helm's Deep strat, dude.
Use my mag po.
That actually doesn't work that well anymore, though. They tweaked the hitboxes on those barrels, and you can actually go over it now. It makes a lot of noise, and it throws you up in the air, but you can actually get in now. You didn't used to be able to. It's still hilarious, though, and most people won't even try to get in. They'll just go around. Oh, that gun is so good. The
Magpul?
PDR.
Yeah, it's alright.
Oh, it's so good. It's like, it's like MP7, but it has a little bit less kick to it.
Yeah, it's recoilless. It's just like...
It's so nice. It's like the SMG from Halo. You just put the crosshair on them and press the button and...
Yeah.
The rate of fire is so
high. What time is it? 8? Okay.
Oh, it's 8 o'clock. 8:15.
I was just looking to see if my race was up. I got me some iRacing races to do.
Look at this clown trying to wallbang with a Modus.
Nah.
Actually,
can that thing wallbang?
I don't know what it's called.
Can that thing wallbang?
Blocking the name of it. The Modus?
Yeah.
Or whatever the hell he's using.
Well, I mean the Modus. Can that wallbang?
Probably not.
Okay.
I think
it would be broken if it could.
Definitely not on
Charge well, it's already broken, but...
If you were just shooting through like a piece of sheet metal or something or a wooden, then yes, but he was trying to shoot through 2 layers of
chain defense
at an angle. You can't do that. You can't even do that with a sniper.
Friendly troops eliminated.
Oh, poor guy.
Operation failure. Return to main base.
Oh, there he goes. Can you still do that thing where you plant on top of the tank and it goes through the floor?
I don't think so.
God, that was amazing. I remember that.
That's so lame.
It made so many people so mad with that.
I think they did. I did away with that real quick.
I'm sure they patched it, but it was hilarious while it lasted. They were so confused.
I would punch like, bricks if someone did that to me.
Walking around staring at the floor trying to find the bomb.
Where's the bomb? What's going on?
There's another one that...
I don't understand!
There's another one that Carl showed me where if they drop the bomb on bridge, there's something that you can do where you glitch it through the wall and it falls out of the map. Can't remember what he did, but it was hilarious.
Enemy troops eliminated. Operation success. Return to main base. Your efforts are commended.
Oh, they did fix it. Okay. This guy says they fixed it.
Yep.
Oh, well, that's a shame. Also, I know for a fact they fixed this one, but... Well, they fixed one of them. There's two ways you can get outside the map. And the first way was, you bounce on the barrel to get up the side of that metal...
Oh, I thought I killed this guy.
...up against the wall outside a warehouse, and you could get on the pipes and run across the pipe...
Oh, I remember that one.
...outside the map. And you can go on the roof.
Granted, I never do it.
There's a new boost to do that, which is easier, and I've actually done it in scrims before, and it was amazing. They were so confused. But there's another one that's old that you can still do, and
Which one was that?
Actually, no, you can't, because you can't buy no glitch anymore, so I take that back.
You can.
It's hard as shit, though. It's not even worth doing anymore.
Alright.
But,
You know, all these glitches you're talking about, I've never done in my life. I've never done lockdown glitches
success.
Or anything like
Return
that.
Return to main base. Your efforts are commended.
I have done nothing whatsoever. So, I'm like, why do these people do all this? I mean,
because no one abused it. They go up on the roofs and hammer blow and have knife fights on the roof. Hilarious. Yeah. I'll show you a video sometime. The other way to get up there, if you can still bind a glitch, I know it's like they tried to patch it and they were mostly successful, but if you can do it, there's a way you can get your teammate to boost you on the sandbags on bridge. Mm-hmm. You can bind them up over the side and get behind the bomb site. And so when your teammate will plant and you'll be sitting behind the bomb site, and because of the way Unreal Engine works, you can see through that wall because there's no
texture. Oh yeah. There's no texture. I have fun issues with that, actually. Usually when you like die or
enemy
something,
troops eliminated.
You'll go
operation
the
success.
Check.
Return to main base. Your efforts are commended.
Behind that fence is where you end up, and you can shoot them through the door of the bomb site while they're defusing. It's really stupid, and I've done it before. It was hilarious.
God dang it.
I'm a terrible person.
You are a very terrible person.
Oh, there's all kinds of... I know all of them now.
Help me out.
That I don't know on the new maps, but at least on the old maps, I know all the spots, man.
Clan True, what?
Although, I'll tell you what, one I didn't know about, I didn't know the boost from Blacksend, where you go on the roof, and until one day we were scrimming, and Snow was like, guys, do the boost. I was like, what boost? And we were all like, what boost? And he's like, there's a boost. I was like, what? And so
enemy troops eliminated.
I'm sure you
operation
see it.
Success. Return to main base. Your efforts are commended.
Oh yeah, that one.
Put someone up on top of the roof in Blacksend.
Yeah.
So you put a scope up there. That's GG. There's nothing they can do. Total mid and warehouse control. From one. You gotta stall them so that you have time to do it, but. There's one similar to that on Hammer Blow that I'm sure you've seen. It happens at double doors. I don't know.
Oh, yeah.
How do you die like that? How do you die like what? I don't understand. Like, what? The stream's on a delay, so I can't see what you're talking about until after. So you're gonna have to explain. See, you're spraying DMR? Yeah, and have you noticed that he's dying, like, really fast?
Yeah, because I'm not paying attention and not caring about...
Not trying. He's not making any effort to adhere to the rules of combat.
Yep.
You run around and spray M14, you're gonna have a bad time.
Yep, and now I have to pee. Right back.
Oh boy, yeah, I didn't...
Friendly troops eliminated. Operation Failure. Return to main base.
Died from MP5. I didn't see that one. You're gonna have to explain what happened.
Wow, I just came back. Oh shit, I'm tightening my belt.
Oh.
On camera. Whoops.
Oh. Nice camis, faggot.
Those aren't camis. Those are fucking ABU shit.
Charge set!
Well, I came through the hole and sprayed him down even though he shot first and only did half. Okay, yeah, that's probably either he fucked up really bad or the guy was lagging. Thing about that is, when you're facing laggers and they peek you first,
charge
like that,
defuse.
Even if you think you shot
Operation
first,
Failure. Return to main base.
On their screen, and so a lot of times the game or the server knows that you're aim punched because they shot you first. And so you go to shoot them, and it looks like you shot them on your client, but you were actually aim-punched or something, and so your bullet missed without you seeing it, and you get sprayed down.
Mm-hmm.
So to the guy that was lagging, it looked like a perfectly normal kill. It looked like Tyrone just didn't even react, or did react, but he was aim-punched and he missed. Unfortunately, the netcode in this game kind of caters towards people that... Well, no, it doesn't. Like, you're technically at a disadvantage if you're lagging, but...
You're at a disadvantage anytime.
The way that the netcode is set up, though, it's very forgiving towards people that have high ping. Because...
Which isn't a bad thing, because because it has to appeal to a certain demographic,
like,
so...
Yeah, it's not like a super hardcore shooter like Counter-Strike, like... If stuff like that could happen in Counter-Strike...
Now, if this game was more popular, I'm pretty sure they would change a few things.
I'm not a network engineer, so I can't, like... I mean, I have a vague idea of how this all works, but I'm basically talking out of my ass here, but...
Yeah, you ass.
I do know that there's a window of time within the server where people can put in damage...
And that's really minuscule.
And the window of time is really big in this game compared to other games, so that people that are lagging don't get completely shit on. And so, normally that would be a good thing, but it's a little bit annoying when you come around a corner, or, well, it doesn't happen when you peek first, but when somebody comes around a corner and because of what the server gives them time to do, you're already getting shot without realizing it. A little weird.
I'm trying to practice my headshot.
Yeah, well, no point in doing that when you're strafing back and forth.
Well, that's how I headshot. I strafe when I headshot.
Well, that's because you use easy guns.
No, I'm practicing for my AK-12.
Yeah, like I said, you use easy guns.
Hey, it takes. It's kind of hard to headshot. It's kind of hard to headshot here.
You do have to aim, but other than that, it does all the work. It has no spread for the first couple shots. It has almost no recoil if you tap it. It has perfect accuracy on the first shot, even if you're moving. Yeah. And almost perfect accuracy even if you're jumping. So it's a pretty crazy gun. I think it
really... Wow, my whole team already died.
It encourages a really cancerous style of play, in my opinion. Which is sprinting around and lottoing the shit out of everyone.
Friendly troops eliminated.
Almost had it.
Operation failure.
Man,
return
guys,
to main base.
Viewers like this whole time.
Yeah, it that's, stays like that. It's that's average.
That's really good though. Like
yeah, that average around 8.
8 people that consistently watch your stream, man. That's more than enough for me. I mean, if there was one guy in the world who every time I set up a stream would sit down and take an hour or so to watch my stream, I would be content with that. I would stream just for that one guy that wanted to see
Whoopsie.
Me play.
Charge set!
That shot. Oh, wow. Okay. That works. Thank you.
Enemy troops eliminated.
Good job, bro.
Operation success. Return to main base. Your efforts are commended.
I could have clutched that, but I was dead set on getting headshots on that first round.
It's 2 a.m. here and I can't stop watching XD.
I'm sorry.
Oh man.
Awkward.
I definitely know that feeling. I do.
Like, what? What was that?
A couple years ago when Carl used to stream and I'd sit down every time and just watch his stream.
Okay, watch what happens.
Friendly troops eliminated.
Some of the people from
Operation
Steel.
Failure.
Oh,
return to main base.
So you shot him.
I thought he was dead.
So you turned around and he somehow
he no-scoped me. He said he no-scoped me.
That's ridiculous.
Wow. Wow.
Oh, this game, man.
There we go.
Hey, look at that spray.
I'm not spraying, I'm tapping.
Well, yeah, that's what I mean, but gun is broken. You're strafing back and forth, just slinging bullets completely
charge
accurately.
Set.
No recoil at all.
It's how you control it, man. It's all how you
enemy
do it.
Troops eliminated.
Reminds me of
Operation Success. Return to main base. Your efforts are commended.
When it was one of the best rifles.
Unable to comply.
It was good because it had such good stability that you could strafe from side to side and still be able to shoot people. So it was good when you were like breaking into a site or something, you could basically walk in and be shooting as you walked in. Be a nerf on strafing and in general, the penalty for jumping in this game is really, really high. Like, you should never jump with anything unless you're point man. And even then, you probably shouldn't jump, but, I do agree that with certain guns, and the AK-12 is one of them, needs to have... And the jumping penalty also is, from what I understand, is dependent on the stability stat of the weapon, too, so... If it's a high stability gun, it'll
charge
have
set.
Less of an accuracy penalty when you're moving around and jumping around. But stuff like AK-12 definitely does need a nerf on stability, because it's really charge. Stupid that you should be able to move around like that
unable
and jump
deploy.
Around like that with a rifle.
Hmm.
Get out of the way.
Hmm. And yes, I
enemy troops eliminated. Operation success. Return to main base. Your efforts are commanded.
You see how I dodged those bullets? Yeah.
Yeah, that's
shit
why
happens.
The AK-12 is so damn strong, because you can
stop.
Move back and forth dodging bullets while you shoot with perfect accuracy. It's ridiculous.
Ouch.
Yeah, they definitely nerf the move shot on snipers. Snipers
ouch.
In this game are really broken. They have perfect move shot when you're holding shift, and some of them have perfect move shot even when you're strafing, which is really dumb. I mean, it wouldn't be as bad if they weren't a one-hit kill, but with snipers like the Mosin and the M4, you get one hit almost every time. It's really stupid that you can strafe back and forth and still be accurate. To give you an idea, like this other guy that's been playing for 5 years.
Enemy troops eliminated. Operation success. Return to main base. Your efforts are commended.
And it was the only sniper in the game that one-shot killed every time. Like, unless you shoot them in the foot, obviously, but because the only other snipers in the game were either the semi-automatics or the SV, which obviously tags a lot, unless you can aim well. But the TPG was technically balanced by the fact that it's extremely slow movement speed, and obviously you can't move when you're shooting it. I mean, you can walk, which I think is dumb. I don't think you should have perfect accuracy when you're walking, but that in of itself would not be so bad. It's just that the new snipers that they're putting in to try and balance the sniper class and make it more viable can, like, strafe around and shoot and still be able to one-shot people. So that's what broke sniper class for me. The other thing that I think is dumb.
Friendly
is
troops eliminated. Operation failure. Return to main base.
Someone calling Cheeks. I don't see you in ESL. Because you hack, man. I've been playing for almost 6 years now. Never been banned.
It might be nice. One thing that might help balance the sniper class is if you have to wait, like, maybe even 100 milliseconds after you zoom in before you can shoot with perfect accuracy. Because it is. Reduce the viability of being able to, like, sprint around and quickscope people by just holding shift and zooming in really fast. Like, that's a pretty broken way to play the sniper, too. Doesn't take very much skill to run around with a one-shot kill gun with perfect accuracy and just quickscope everyone.
I want to know his logic.
Wait, what?
No, I'm typing in here.
Oh, the guy that's calling you a hacker.
Enemy troops eliminated. Operation success. Return to main base. Your efforts are commended.
Well, I mean, if you don't want to listen to me, then just leave the stream, because I'm not going to stop.
We're talking. I'm answering this. It's conversation. Yeah. So, I mean, I'm also talking to him, so it's kind of.
If you don't want to watch, and just go. Like, we're not streaming just to cater.
Enemy
to you
troops
guys.
Eliminated.
It's awesome that you're watching.
Operation success. Return to main base. Your efforts are commended.
Yeah, exactly. Well, be honest. I stream for the entertainment of others, but I also like to entertain myself. So if I want to talk to my friends, I mean, that's me.
Sit in silence and.
Yeah, that's kind of boring. I mean, I haven't had a conversation like this in like years, so it's kind of. I'd rather talk about something. Like, yeah, helps me aim, helps me relax.
A little chat. Guys, like, leaping to my defense. Just nail, shut the fuck up, lol. I mean, that's that. I could have. I put it nicely, but yeah, pretty much what he said.
I mean, I can ban you from the stream, but I wouldn't do that. I mean, I'm not that kind of person, so. Relax. No, I saw him. He just killed me. I wasn't quick enough. Usually, it's all about reaction time. And, I mean, he saw me, and I saw him. I actually saw him first. It might have It might have not looked like it, but I actually saw him. I already knew he was there. So, it's not really a thing of sight. It's more of reaction.
I think there are more people here who want him talking. Aw, that's pretty nice. And that may be true, maybe not, but...
Charge set!
He'll lagger peek you and he kill... Oh, yeah. I mean...
I saw it, but...
That happens when they peek first. Whoever peeked, and it's like this in most FPS games anyway, just whoever peeked first usually gets the advantage.
Mm-hmm. Friendly troops eliminated.
Sometimes
operations failure. Return to main base.
Okay, 12 months, long range barrel and grip.
Like, part of it is the netcode, and then another part of it is when you're peeking a corner, you are all tense and ready and you expect someone to be around that corner and you're focused, but the guy who's sitting there watching the angle, if he's been sitting there for like 20 seconds just looking at the same place, he might not be as alert and ready to react as the guy who's peeking is. So that's another part of it.
Oh, I didn't know that guy was there.
If you peek someone first, you get the drop on them because you're expecting them to be there and they don't know if you're going to peek them or not.
Enemy troops eliminated.
And
operation success. Return to main base. Your efforts are commended.
Watch one place. Like you stay in a place and you have a spot and you watch that spot. So it's a little easier in that regard, but when you're attacking, you have to check everything. You have to watch every single way they can come from. This is why when you see pro players playing, a lot of the times you'll see their crosshair moving around all over the place. To constantly be aware of your surroundings. Gross.
Excuse me. I apologize.
Good. Apology accepted.
I feel like playing Battlefield all of a sudden.
Yeah.
What? I'm not playing CSGO.
I don't want to play CSGO either. I stopped playing that game, actually. I got really into it.
I got frustrated.
I got really into it for like a month or two, and then there was like so many hackers that I just couldn't play anymore.
Frustration.
Like, there's less hackers in CSGO by density of the population. Like, there's less hackers per player, I guess. I don't know how I would say that. But,
ouch. Ouch. Why are they still there?
Because they all play the competitive matchmaking and people will like be with their friends who are hacking. It's like Match Channel in AVA, like at the high ranks of AVA Match Channel, it's all hackers, and it's the same with CSGO. Like once you get past the highest I've got in CSGO is like Master Guardian something, which I guess isn't that high. I mean, it's higher than average, obviously, but from what I've heard from other people, especially my friends who are up in the higher ranks, once you get past like Master Guardian Elite or Distinguished Master Guardian or so, it's like all hackers. Like, and not people complaining that someone's beating them and saying they're hacking, like people that are boosting their friends up to the highest rank with cheats, like 360 no scope aimbot all over the place.
Which
I
is pretty sad. I can't
is
stand
really
that.
Sad. Like I don't know why you'd want to be boosted up to that kind of rank if it doesn't reflect your actual skill. But I mean, I guess whatever makes your EPing bigger. And then there's the people that do it just to ruin the game, which is even more sad.
Oh, what a headshot.
But yeah, that's why we don't play CSGO.
I don't. I can't.
Charge defuse. Operation success. Return to main base. Your efforts are
so
commended.
Like, I will play the competitive game mode, but not the matchmaking servers. I'll play on community servers, and I play with friends. So it's basically like the pubs in AVA.
Ouch! Holy crap! How do you get there so quick?
That's the only way I can
stop. Oh wait, it's point man. Okay, I see. Okay, no more scope. I guess. Scope.
What? How do you play with one hand?
One hand. What?
If you have
I'm confused.
And you're trying to play AVA, you're gonna have a hard time with that. I don't think you can really play FPS.
Help.
There's a charge set. Guy that I've seen in the past who plays CS:GO, and he actually doesn't have any hands.
Friendly troops eliminated.
His arms
operation failure. Return to main base.
Like and he plays CS:GO with the stumps of his arms, and he's actually extremely good. Like he's better than me.
What?
It's pretty crazy. Well,
looks like Josh is a bad player now. Looks like Josh is a bad player now.
Oh.
Alright, I think I'm done for a bit.
Yeah, Handy, you've seen him. That's pretty damn impressive. I mean, I can't even imagine.
Alright, I'm done for a bit for streaming. I might play some Battlefield.
As you clutch two in India, you played with one hand. What? Maybe the webcam is on delay or something, because he definitely has two hands and plays with both of them, so.
Well, I mean, you can see my setup here, you know, the Zoe and the keyboard, yeah, two hands, and the monitor, yeah, it's 144 hertz, son, yeah, and then my PC.
Oh,
look at that! Look at that PC.
Is that a Ripper XXL, by the way?
Yeah.
Your pad? Yeah, I want one.
Yeah, there's my PC. My new case. Look at that case. Beautiful, ain't it?
He does have a very nice case.
Look inside. Yeah, look at that 770.
His left hand was in his face, and he moved and shoot at the same time.
Oh.
Yeah, I think the webcam's probably on a delay there, bud, because there's no way he did that. He lives in, like, barracks-type deal. He's in the Air Force.
Look at that. That looks beautiful. Yeah, I'm in the Air Force, man. I live in dorms.
Or dorms.
Look at that's my old case over there. I threw that piece of trash out of here.
Were you there for, the case thing, the discussion we were having?
What?
I was talking to Carl about cases and the computers that we used to have, and he showed me the case that his dad bought him on his first computer, and it was ugly as shit.
Oh.
I mean, I'm sure you've seen, he posted a picture on Facebook, I think, a while ago of his original setup. He probably showed that to you. And he had the cheesy ass speakers and shit, and everything was all white, and it was like really reminiscent of like 2006. It's hilarious.
You're getting these drops, card drops. What is card drop?
What now?
On Steam, card drops on Steam for Ava. Nope.
There's no okay.
Oh.
Why? He, like, plays with hackers.
As long as he's not a hacker, it's fine. I don't really give a damn.
Ugh. Well, there's no trading cards for AVA, so I don't know what he's talking about. Unless they put him in yesterday. I don't know.
Alright, I'm shutting down the stream. I might play Battlefield in a sec. Wait, actually... 9:40. What time does the race start? 10:40. Okay, yeah, I'll be playing some Battlefield.